ما قال النبي هو الصحيح نكاح مبارك نكاح مبارك زواج مبارك النكاح من سنتي ما قال النبي هو الصحيح نكاح مبارك
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome again, brothers and sisters, to another episode in the series of Marriage and Divorce with myself and Sheikh Haitham al-Haddad. Sheikh Haitham al-Haddad is currently residing in the UK and is on the board of the Sharia Council of Britain and is also the founder of the website www.islam21c.com. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh.
Alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We have started to get into the subject of a successful marriage. And you mentioned a few points in the last episode. Have you got anything further you'd like to add?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Yes, we spend a good time in discussing what make a marriage successful. Let me mention a few other points that might serve as a summary. Or maybe, in fact, they are new points. By the way, of course, we have limited time in this program. We cannot discuss every single case, and we cannot just explore more and more. Yeah? What I wanted to say, that firstly we said that each party should observe his obligation and fulfill his rights.
Yes.
Secondly, we said that each party should show extra love, or should show love, even if this party does not love. And we said that, in particular, the wife should show more love.
And this way, she can control the family.
And she can control the family, and that the family can move smoothly. Thirdly, we said upon the husband to show two important qualities. Being a protector from all angles, financially, security, emotionally, physically. Yeah? Physically, I always make a joke. I said, if the man is sleeping next to his wife and in the middle of the night there was a burglar or a sound or some noise, and then he will say to her, darling, yeah, there is some noise downstairs, just go and check. She will say, what is this man? I don't feel secure next to him. Even this small thing, yeah, she should feel that he is really a man. Okay? And by the way, all women like to see, we mentioned it anyway, to see that their husbands are exercising a level of authority over them. As men like to see a level of obedience, yeah, and submission to them by their wives. Okay? So this is one. That the husband should be a protector and should show care, in particular love, but in particular care for the wife. This, in general, will keep a very good marriage, a very healthy marriage. There are some other maybe measures to be taken if there are problems. If there is an argument, there is misunderstanding, there is a dispute. I always say the formula that is used, IFF, IFF, ignore, forgive, and forget. Yeah? Ignore, what does ignore mean? Ignoring in general, or pretending that you are unaware, or forget it, yeah? Or overlook it, is a very important principle in our life to live with others.
Generally.
Generally, in an amicable way. With your parents, with your neighbor, with your employers, with your employee, with your friend, with your brother, generally. Right? And they say that this was mentioned in the Quran. And the original evidence for this was mentioned in the Quran. وَإِذْ أَسَرَّ النَّبِيُّ إِلَىٰ بَعْضِ أَزْوَاجِهِ حَدِيثًا فَلَمَّا نَبَّأَتْ بِهِ وَأَظْهَرَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ عَرَّفَ بَعْضَهُ وَأَعْرَضَ عَنْ بَعْضٍ فلما نبأها به قالت من أنبأك هذا؟ قال نبأني العليم الخبير. Okay. The translation of this is And remember when the Prophet ﷺ has disclosed a secret to one of his wives. Then she disclosed the secret. Allah Jalla wa'ala informed him about that secret that she has disclosed. What happened? He went to her. And he informed her that she disclosed part of his secret. He did not tell her that she what? Informed all secrets or all elements of the secret. Yeah? She said, who told you this? He said, Allah, Al-Alim Al-Khabir. He's the one who informed me that you disclosed the secret. There is a long story about this, but anyway, because we have a very limited time, we need to just to mention the gesture of this. The scholar said that the Prophet ﷺ did not tell his wife, and you have disclosed this, and you have disclosed this, and you have disclosed this. No. He said, you have disclosed this. She will understand now that, oh, maybe he doesn't know about the other part. She will feel more embarrassed. This is to keep a face and not to put down the other side completely.
This is the wife we're talking to, it's not...
This is the wife, yeah? Don't embarrass the other person, right? And that's why the scholar said, مَسْتَقْصَى كَرِيمٌ قَطْ. A noble person will not follow and chase all the mistakes of others. Yeah? Subhanallah. Imam Ahmad was asked about this pretending that you are unaware, التغافل. They told him that 9 out of 10 of akhlaq, of good manners, yeah, lie on التغافل. He said, no. All akhlaq, not 9 out of 10 of the akhlaq. All the akhlaq, all the good manners and etiquettes are based on what? Pretending that you are unaware. See, me and you are friends going together, walking together. I might do something indecent, you might do something indecent. Then if I say, ha, 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 you do this. This is very unnoble, undecent reaction. Obviously, any one of us will fall into mistakes, will have shortcomings. This is life. If I want to chase your mistakes and you want to chase my mistakes, it doesn't work. Similarly, yeah? Me and my wife, yeah? One time I came, she has not cooked well. Just ignore it. Ignore it. One time I was expecting some, maybe that she dressed up for me and she didn't do that. One time I came, maybe I approached her, I found that her breath is bad. You have a bad breath. No. And similarly, she has to observe this with me.
Otherwise, like we mentioned in previous episodes, you start to compete with each other.
To compete with each other. And many people say, and especially wives, they say, he is picking on me. Mm. Yes. Even, subhanAllah, in general, you know that your children are doing something indecent. Yeah? Or wrong. In some cases, yes, maybe indecent things you have to speak to them. But in some cases, just tell them about certain things, not about everything. Otherwise, what will happen? They will lose your respect. They will not respect you anymore because now they are exposed. They can't do anything. Yeah? So keep a face, as they say. Yeah? Act in a very, oblivious way.
Very oblivious, yes.
Yeah? Be that kind of that person. And this will keep the marriage intact. Keep any relationship intact. Okay? Obviously, a husband and wife will go through so many things between them. Yeah? If they don't ignore such things between them or pretend that they are unaware, yeah, then so many problems will take place. Again, the second one, this is ignore. The second one we have is forgive. You know, Allah Jalla wa Ala commanded Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to forgive in general because this is a very important etiquette or attitude that needs to be observed in order to live with other people. خذ العفو وأمر بالعرف وأعرض عن الجاهلين. خذ العفو means observe. Yeah? Act on forgiveness or show forgiveness. Yeah? خذ العفو means master it.
We all make mistakes. We all need to be forgiven and we all need to forgive.
So if you cannot ignore, if it happened that you did not ignore, if it happened that the matter was exposed between me and you on what you have done or what I have done, you forgive me, I forgive you. Between me and my wife, we need to be forgiving for each other. Seriously, Brother Daniel, maybe we need a program to talk about forgiveness, a series to talk about forgiveness, because I found that this character is missing in many Muslims.
And this is part
it's not observed in many communities.
Part of the tarbiyah of a person.
It is part of the tarbiyah. Allah Jalla wa Ala praised those who forgive. Allah Jalla wa Ala said, "Wa anta'fu aqrabu lit-taqwa." When you forgive, yeah, this is nearer to taqwa. Allah Jalla wa Ala also says, "Wal ya'fu wal yasfahu ala tuhibbuna yaghfir Allahu lakum." Yeah, let them pardon and forgive. Don't you love that Allah Jalla wa Ala should forgive you? Many verses that talk about forgiveness. Yeah, it is not a lecture about forgiveness, but this is a reminder that it is a very important element to keep a healthy marriage.
Jazakallah khair. Brothers and sisters, please return so we can continue the discussion about a successful marriage and see what other points the Sheikh has to mention. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Marriage or divorce?
What's Islamic ruling?
Nikah.
Love book.
Solution or problem?
Islam to
heaven or hell?
There is a misconception.
You choose. Beauty, wealth, family status, virtue. Decide what you want. Decide your choice. Be sad or be happy. It's your choice. Join Dr. Zakir Naik in Better Half, Bitter Half every Friday at 6:30 p.m. and repeat telecast at 9:30 a.m. UK on Peace TV. The value of money in the hereafter will be measured by its proper use in the present.
Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu anfiqu mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya yawmun la bay'un fihi wa la khullatun wa la shafa'a.
According to the glorious Quran, one of the best ways to use your money is to spend it in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by spreading His message of Islam. Peace TV is a non-profit Islamic satellite television channel that is primarily dedicated for just that cause, the proper presentation of Islam. It's a great choice to invest in it and a golden opportunity to purify your wealth in a way that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Support Peace TV. Send your zakat and donations to IRFI, Al Rayan Bank, 47 Calthorpe Road, Birmingham, UK. B151TH. Pound account number 01132301. IBAN GB49ARAY 3000830113230 1. Sort code 300083. SWIFT BIC code ARAY GB22. Please confirm your contribution at support@peacetv.tv.
Support Peace TV, the solution for humanity.
Most countries of the world ban bullying. They fight it in their schools and universities. A lot of us are being bullied differently every single day. Some come up to us and say, "Do this," while others say, "Don't you dare." Some say this is halal, halal, while others say, nope, this is haram. Are you confused? Do you feel lost? Join me in Umdatul Ahkam, where, with the grace of Allah, we will learn the proper knowledge from the Quran and from the Sunnah, which would help stop this kind of bullying.
Join Asim Al-Hakim in Umdatul Ahkam, next on Peace TV.
An-nikahu min sunnati.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome again, brothers and sisters, to the discussion where myself and Sheikh Haitham Al-Haddad are talking about the different ingredients for a successful marriage. Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
You covered the point of ignoring certain things, and now you're on to forgiveness.
Yeah, we mentioned about forgiveness. We can talk a lot about it, yeah, but we have a limited time, and the aim of this discussion is not to focus on akhlaq, on manners, but to remind the husband and the wife of the key akhlaq that they need to observe in order to achieve a healthy marriage. Yeah? So aside from the previous things that we have mentioned, we said three main elements need to be observed. Yeah? As a recipe, or sometimes as a cure for what may happen between both of you. The first one is ignore or pretend that you are unaware or acting in an oblivious way. The second one is forgiving. And the third one is forgetting. Yeah? Many wives in particular, they keep a list of the mistakes of their husbands. Seriously. And when they come, they attend in the Islamic Sharia Council. She will say, Sheikh, yeah? And some of them bring documents. On this date, he did this. Other date, he done that. On the other date, the husband will say, wow. Why are you keeping all of this? One time, one of the senior du'at said, Sheikh, I really need to sit with you and I need to bring my wife. I said, what, ya akhi, you are, mashallah, mature da'i. He said, please, she wants another person. So I said, okay, no problem. I remember even I told, in order just to maybe avoid sitting with them, because he's a senior da'i, I don't want to embarrass him, and I'm sure that his wife will complain about him, etc. I don't want to embarrass him. So I said, wallahi, you know that I'm traveling, akhi. The only time I can give is today. Yeah? He said, I have very short notice, but let me see, okay, whether my wife will come or not. I said, alhamdulillah, now, obviously, short notice. Then he rang me and he said, coming. I said, oh, no way. Women can't lose this, such opportunities. Anyway, he came with his wife. She said, basically, to cut it short, that, you know, my husband is a senior da'i and he speaks, yeah, in public and, okay, what is your main problem? She said that he speaks casually with sisters. I said, what do you mean? She said, for example, Sheikh, one time he said to one of the sisters, dear sister, and then she responded to him by saying, oh, mashallah, when you attended on the stage, you were glooming. I said, just give me examples. You are exaggerating. So she picked an email. She came with a file like this, wallahi. And then she picked an email. Yeah? Now if they are watching us, then she will become angry. Anyway, she's not known, he's not known, but she will know. And then she read the email. Okay? Maybe a dear sister, as she said. I said, when was this? They came to me, I think, in 2012, something like this. The email was sent in 2006.
6 years.
I said to her, sister, what is the date again? She said, 2006. I said, subhanallah. Do you have another example? She was looking, searching through. She said, yeah, there are many. I said, yeah, show me another example. She said, oh, maybe I left them at home. I said, sister, and you are keeping an email from 2006? Fear Allah, sister. This is not the attitude of a woman who wants to be obedient and who wants to have a successful marriage. You have a beautiful husband. Don't destroy the relationship because of not forgetting. Yeah? And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam warned women in particular, إِنِّي رَأَيْتُكُنَّ أَكْثَرَ أَهْلِ النَّارِ. I have seen you the most in the fire of hell. Most of the people in the fire of hell. They said, why, Ya Rasulullah? Yeah? He said, وَتَكْفُرْنَا الْعَشِيرِ. He mentioned this important quality. Yeah? What is تَكْفُرْنَا الْعَشِيرِ? They said, what is تَكْفُرْنَا الْعَشِيرِ? If the husband was very good to you and he does something, one thing bad, you will say, I have never seen any good thing from you. Yeah? This is Kufran al-Ashir. The Prophet ﷺ warned women from having it. Yeah? Because of one thing, she forgot everything. We are saying the opposite. Forget shortcomings. We need to forget the shortcomings of each other, the mistakes of each other. We said, first of all, ignore. It happened that you could not ignore. Forgive. Don't forgive and keep it in your mind, and then you bring it back whenever there is a dispute.
Use it when you need it.
Use it when you need it. No. You ignored it. You couldn't. You forgave it. Yeah? Yes. You must forget it.
Oh, but that's something that's going to play on your mind.
Yes. Okay? And it will keep accumulating. And because many people don't forget, yeah? Because many people don't forget, what will happen? They will be depressed. And that's why we see many men and many women, and women in particular, because of their nature, yeah? Falling into depression, yeah? In the West. Why? Because they accumulate things. They put it in the bank. They put it in the bank. Put it in the bank. And then all of a sudden, what happened? The cup overflows or cannot hold the water, and the water just spills everywhere. So this is a very important element in order to keep a healthy marriage. So forget. The last thing I would like to mention before ending this episode, I think I mentioned it before, but I just want to recap, is, my dear brothers and sisters, as I said in one of the episodes, look at this marriage as a project that both of you wish or aim to make it successful.
Together.
Together. Okay? Or each side. Not necessarily together, mutually together. No. Each side. Me, I should look at it like this. My wife should look at it like this as well. Why? Because the minute you give yourself the impression that you can leave this project, you can let it down, you can fail this project, you will fail. And they always say, if you get into any kind of competition or fight with an opposite person, and if you have the impression that you will lose, you will lose. Yeah? If you have confidence that you will win, you will win, or likely to win.
It's psychological as well.
Psychological. I don't know whether I mentioned it or not. But what is the difference between a person renting a flat or a property and a person who is buying it? The person who is buying it, will look after the society or the community around him, will look after the street, the cleanliness, the security, safety, etc. Because there is commitment. He is not going into that thinking that he can leave whenever he wants. But the rented place, the person say, well, it's not my place, I can leave whenever I want. Treat your marriage as a project that must be successful, and it will be successful. But if you treat your marriage as a casual relationship that you can leave it whenever you want, then it will not be a successful one. That's why the first element women want from marriage is what? Commitment. Yeah, commitment and security, it comes with protection. I'm talking about the relationship, okay? Commitment. And that's why, subhanAllah, non-Islamic societies that have damaged family values will never be successful.
No.
Why? Because no family, no solid family structure, no commitment. It is a casual relationship. Okay? Whenever I want, I go into this casual relationship. Whenever I want to leave, I will leave. Easily.
No duties, no commitments, no responsibility.
No commitment to nothing. Now, subhanAllah, because of this, many liberal societies try to make marriage as a very ultra committed relationship, whereby ending it is a nightmare. It's so difficult. As a result of this, yeah, people started to what?
Not marry.
Avoid marriage. They try to avoid being married in the first place.
They just live together now without the...
They said, oh, if leaving it is so difficult, is a nightmare, why do I need to put myself into that situation? And that's why we need to, maybe we have discussed a lot about marriage, we need to go and discuss the issue of divorce, the ruling of divorce, because sometimes the husband and wife might come to a decision that it is not working. Yeah? How to deal with it? They need to maybe just separate. طيب فإمساكم بمعروف أو تسريح بإحسان. Stay together in goodwill, amicably, or leave each other amicably as well. This is life, it is a test, and different people have different, yani, they go through different difficulties and the challenges.
Inshallah, I think now that we have talked about the whole, the marriage side of it, and before marriage, I think inshallah in the future, in the next episode, we will start the subject of divorce.
Inshallah, inshallah. I think we have discussed enough about marriage and what keeps or what maintains a healthy marriage.
Jazakumullah khair, everyone, for attending the episode so far. Make sure you continue, because now we're getting onto the topic of divorce. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
نكاح مبارك مبارك زواج مبارك مبارك النكاح من سنتي